In the previous section, we have understood how to import financial data from various sources and visualize them. In this section, we will learn about another important library in Python known as NumPy. NumPy is an acronym for Numeric Python or Numerical Python. It is an open source extension module for Python. NumPy provides us with two major things. It provides fast precompiled functions for mathematical and numerical routines on any variable or object. Further, it enriches the Python programming language with powerful data structures such as multidimensional arrays and matrices. Using NumPy, one can even manipulate these arrays and matrices to perform high-level mathematical operations on them. So a natural question here is, what is an array, and why are they important? An array is a list of related values, that is, every value in an array is of the same data type, and is only differentiated by the position within the array. Consider this example to understand the anatomy of an array. Here, we have used the np.array constructor function to create this two-dimensional array out of three individual lists. What we mean by two-dimension is that the data is stored across two axes, one for the rows, and other for the columns. The object A is of the array data type, while the elements within this array are of the same data type integer. This shape of this array is a 3x3 array, that is, it consists of three rows and three columns. The indexing of both these rows and columns begin from 0, that is, the three columns are indexed as 0, 1, 2, and the three rows are indexed as 0, 1, 2. For example, if we want to know the position of element 900 within the array, then it lies at 2, 2, and that of element 300 is 0, 2. The reason why arrays are important are: first, they help us to understand the rules of a dataset, which exhibit a dimension greater than 1. In Python for finance, understanding array manipulation are a natural predecessor to manipulating financial data frames. Arrays helps us build our fundamentals on higher dimensional datasets, especially two-dimension datasets. Second, they help us to conduct an operation or apply a function to a complex object like an array at once rather than iterating over the single elements of the object. This increases the efficiency of the programming language, at the same time makes numerical computations on objects more capable and efficient. This is known as vectorization. Consider this example, where we are adding, subtracting, multiplying scalars to a particular array. Third, arrays help in broadcasting. Broadcasting allows us to combine objects of different shapes and within a single operation. Here, we have multiplied the one-dimensional array B with a two-dimensional array A. The vector 1, 2, 3 is multiplied to every row in this example. This can be observed by looking at the output. Again, broadcasting helps to increase the efficiency of the programming language. We will learn more on vectorization and broadcasting in the upcoming IPython notebooks. But for now, we will end this short introduction on NumPy, after peppering you with a couple of quiz questions on this topic. Are you ready for the quiz?